Good afternoon, curling fans. Welcome to the 2017 Under-21s AMJ Campbell Nova Scotia Men's Championship. Here today, for your listening pleasure, is myself, Marianne McCauley, and my husband, Phil Redden. We're happy to be here today as your commentators.
Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome aboard.
So today, we're going to feature a game on Ice 3, which is Team Lefort out of the Sydney Curling Club playing against Team McDonah from the Truro Curling Club. Team McDonah has Hammer. The teams did a draw to the button, and Team McDonah earned the right to the draw to the last rock in this first end. And the game is on the way.
As you can see, Team McDonah throwing the hammer stones. They're playing the blue rocks with Lefort throwing yellow. First rock heading down the ice. A little heavy by the looks of things. Maybe coming into a top four area of the house.
The ice looks pretty good, eh, Phil? We were watching the practice. It looks like there's some pretty nice swing here today.
Yeah, I did a few split times early on. Looked like your draw was running around 14 and a half seconds from hog to hog. One side of the ice a little straighter than the other. It'll work itself out here as the game goes along, I'm sure.
Here, look like they're going to play a pretty open first end. And we've got a hit. We're probably going to lose that shooter rock. Unless it hangs on. Nope, just rolled out. So one thing about interesting fact about both of these teams is probably the average age out there is only about 16, and Team Lefort's been playing together for 6 years, while Team McDonough's been playing together for 4 years. Both teams have had one little shift up due to losing a member to graduation, but it's nice to see these teams that stick together and work together and learn the little things about each other as a team, and it certainly always helps their game.
Nice guard throw in there by the lead stone on the fort, setting up here now for a few more rocks in play. I see McDonah calling a shot to the open side, trying to get a little bit more defensive strategy starting out here.
That's always probably a good idea in the first end. You don't want to make it too complicated and keep it kind of simple.
We do have three other games going on this afternoon as well. On sheet one, we have Jackson throwing the yellow stones, playing against Purcell, throwing blue. On sheet two, we've got Dalton throwing yellow against Weagle, throwing the blue stones. And then on sheet four, we've got Team Manuel throwing yellow, playing against Team Abraham throwing blue. As the game progresses, we'll try to keep you up to date on the scoring as best we can along the sheets. Nice throw there by Team McDonah.
Yeah, so the second stone on Team McDonah that just delivered that rock is... No, actually, I think, Phil, that was still the lead stone. That was David McCurdy threw that. And David's only been curling 3 years, so... we actually belong to the same club as Team McDonah, and it's pretty impressive for David how short a time he's played the game and how well he's picked up the game. Oh, I think we may have a miss. This is probably, as most curlers know, the hardest part of the game, the early part of the game, having to throw those hits to the wings and never really quite sure how much curl you're going to get. So looks like we got some curl there, and we'll keep an eye on that. I see they're going to go to the wings on the other side.
Ice is curling about 5.5 feet from the inside out, we call it. A couple spots that run a little straighter, but you know, ice is well set up for today's game. Good curl, good speed.
Looks like Alex McDonah may have found nice draw weight, nice and even with the one on the other side, which is great. So there's less chance of a double across the sheet. So they're going to go after the same rock that they did the last time. And I see it's just taken a couple inches outside the stone. So let's see how this one runs. Oh. Yes, they. Looks like that one. I think they probably should have got on that a little quicker. That one's going as well.
Turner's got a piece, I think. Yeah. He's going to get a piece, but I think he's going to roll out across the sheet. Evan helping it out.
That's a pretty good sign of good ice. That rock broke hard as it got near the hog line, and that's good. Makes for an interesting game when you have that hard finish and you have to anticipate the sweeping and to make your rock stay. All right, so we're going to take Evan's calling for his brother Alex. So the skip and the second stone are brothers. So he's calling for Alex to come around.
Mine looks pretty good. Got a 340 split from back line to hog on that one. So looks like it's going to finish in there pretty good, close to the top four.
Very nice weight.
Very nice weight, T line. Partially open though. Like looks like Lefort's going to play a little tap bump on this. Not looking to remove the stone, but more just try to get that to the back of the house and get a little set up position there for his next rock.
So we're at third stones here now. Nicholas McKenzie delivering the stone for Team Lefort. Nicholas is 17 and been curling for 7 years.
Sweeping it hard. Looks like he's got good weight for a freeze. Yeah, nicely well, down on top.
Yes,
of
it is. Yeah.
Evan looking for a nose hit here, I think.
But with pretty, that looks with that ice, though, that he's just going to do it with some soft weight.
Yeah, nice little easy tap weight here.
Looks like he threw that pretty good.
Had him right up the stick on that one. Hard line on this. By nicely. Looks like he's got a great shot here.
Well, he didn't remove it, but he's certainly making for an interesting situation now with three blues in the house. Yellow is sitting second, but they'll have to try to remove some rocks here to make sure that that the blue doesn't build up a big end.
Just overcurled a little tiny bit there and didn't quite get the position behind that center guard that he was looking for. This one looks like it's a little tiny bit out, holding, riding that 4 foot line all the way down. Just got a sliver of it, just to knock it out through those two stones, and I think Evan could hit lie three here, put some real pressure on the 14.
So throwing for the Team McNutt team now is Adam McEachren. Adam is 15 years old in grade 10 at Cobequid Educational Center in Truro.
Weight's down a bit on this one, but
no, I think it looks good. They better
real good. It's holding there a little bit though. Just a little off nose. Is it gonna hang around?
Nope.
Oh no, unlucky there. Sure, it looks like he's playing the hit and roll there, Marion. I think that was the call.
Yeah, I think that's the call. That's a good call. You hit this one and roll over right in front of the other blue one. If it happens to get a little thin, you might actually be able to play the double as well.
Yeah, I think initially he looked at maybe playing the double, but realized that maybe it was a little tougher and the hit and roll would probably get a better position to put the force on. So that one there is reasonably well thrown. Sweepers are on it there now, on off a little bit here. Coming down, looking for the roll.
Looking pretty good.
Pretty good.
Looking pretty good. Very, very nice shot.
Frozen right on top of that stone of
great shot by Sébastien Lefort. I'm going to force Team McDonah to draw, and it's quite a change. That's how the game is, Phil. 1 minute you think the blue's going to sit three, and now they're forced into a draw to the 4 foot.
He's taking the out turn side this time, throwing down the right hand side of the sheet. Haven't seen a whole lot being thrown down here so far this end, so you'll have to be a little careful on the weight. Could still be a little sticky, even though they've had a couple of practice ends. Still could be a little sticky on this side. Trying to get a split time here for you and see what that turns out to be. A pretty good split. .340 for a split. I think they better get on that one. Looks like it's just starting to come down a little bit here. It's coming in. It's got great line. Great line. They're yelling hard for sweep. Looks like it just came up.
Just like you said, we haven't played down this side a lot, and sometimes it you get near the hog line there, and wasn't a little fresh and dug in a little bit on them.
So now
Sébastien will try to come in the other side, and I expect he'd be pretty contented even if he come up a little short and guard it off this side, but I expect he's trying to come right top four, put some real pressure on them.
Absolutely, get one in here, just top four, top button, buried behind cover, real pressure on. Well, sweepers are on it right away. Sweeping hard, they're off now. Oh, back on again. It's got good line.
That's a great shot.
Great shot. Partially exposed. Almost.
Yeah, I think if he the angle we're at here, we couldn't see with the sweepers how close he was getting by the guard. I think it was a pretty tough shot to get in there to get to nose, so it kind of looks like he'd probably be pretty happy if he just, even if he wasn't able to get number one out of this, if he was just to get rid of it and he gave up one, it wouldn't be a bad start. Let's see if he can get this rock to nose, because I think if he gets to nose, he's number one.
I believe so. The weight's a little high here.
I think at this point, if I'd think they should play the pick.
Yeah, it's a little high. The weight was just a little heavy there.
Yeah, there. So that's one for Team Lefort in the first end. And the scoreboards aren't marked on the other ends. Most have started their second end. Except for an ice two, there's a tremendous amount of rocks in play in ice two. Yeah, looks like...
Looks like they're sitting a couple in there, but no. Looks like there's a Dalton Rock in the middle there. So.
We'll give you an update on the other sheets once they post their scores. All right, so let's see how they're going to approach this end. It looks like he's calling for a guard, so they're not scared to play with rocks. They're going to get right at it. Needs to curl a little bit. It rides the 4 foot line there for a long time, but then has some pretty nice finish once from the hog line in.
Looks to be pretty quick. I had over a 4 split on that one, so ice is really keening up here as we're moving along.
So if anybody was wondering there, Evan went out to the Yellow Rock and talked to his team about whether they might want to push that aside and make a couple corners, and they've decided they're going to come around. Looks like he's got lots of weight.
Yeah, lots of weight. But this side runs a little straighter than the other side, so it finishes up as it gets across the hog line here, but it's coming in nice. Oh, I mean, real nice line. Kevin decided to take that a little deep because it was going to be a little deep, I think, anyways. So
game on. Looks like we're going to have an interesting end. So I mentioned on ice two, the Weagle-Dalton game had a tremendous amount of rocks in play, and at the end of it, Weagle picked up one.
Looking across the other two sheets, the blank ends, Marion, from what I can see down there.
Oh, you're right. I didn't notice that, so.
Our
feature sheet here, we came up short, so looks like Team McDonah would...
get possession of the 4 foot if he gets one top four here behind two yellow guards.
They're signaling that this rock's a little heavy, so I would tend to agree. Just watching it from our vantage point, this certainly looks like it actually may be quite deep in the house, if not through. Now, if it
might kind of catch a piece of that one, maybe. No, not quite.
No. Yes, if it had caught a little piece of that blue, I think that would have stayed in play.
Yep. Gone through the house, just barely through the back 12. Ford's got a chance now to try that same shot again. Come right down there on top of that McDonah stone. Good line, but again,
that looks heavy as well.
Sweepers are gesturing us up there.
It actually looks quicker to me than the last one, so quite sure this one's going through the house.
As I mentioned to you, that guard, I got a fast split time, so it must be really keening up here compared to what it was in the first end.
Which is great. I mean, I think these teams, you know, the winner of this championship will go on to represent Nova Scotia at the 2017 Canadian Junior in Estimalt, BC, from January 21st to 29th. And when you go to a national championship, they have very... fast ice, and so it's tremendous that we're providing the players the opportunity to play on ice with some swing and good speeds, so that's good experience for them. Again, I think this one's coming down the fast track. This one looks maybe slightly less, but
it should break a little bit after it gets off that 4 foot line, but it takes a while for it to finish up. I think the weight's actually pretty good.
One thing about both of these teams that we read about both of them, that they both play in the competitive league in their clubs. There's not a strong number of junior teams that play competitively, so the senior and I guess I shouldn't say senior, but the adult league competitive have allowed both these teams and their individual clubs to play in that, and I think that's a tremendous opportunity for these players, and it's a great experience for them.
This side of the sheet, as I mentioned to you, had quite a bit more curl to it when we noticed in practice, and you can see it breaking hard as it's coming into the house.
It's looking like a nice rock.
They're just finishing it up.
Very nice.
Very nice throw. I still think.
I think if you play.
Kind of shot, yeah, exactly. Get position on this. It's Evan's called here. Just a nice little hack weight kind of shot.
Yeah, I didn't notice the weight call there, Phil. Was it a hack that he called,
yeah,
or back line?
It's a hack weight kind of a call. Yeah. he's not hollering for line. It's really riding that 4 foot line again before it breaks. Just a little outside the broom there, but here it comes. Don't think it's going to come enough though, but that's going to be okay. He's got some opportunities here still. That yellow rock's kind of lonely in there amongst those three blue stones right now.
It's an interesting call. He's coming in from the other side, so he doesn't set up the double. If he came down the other side and didn't place it quite right, he could probably set up a double. So this is interesting, and he chose not to hit that top blue one.
That 4 foot area is, I think, his goal here.
Yeah, very aggressive call.
It looks a little light, Marion. Sweeping it hard, but I think he's going to come up like he is. I think Evan still might have the same opportunity here on this outturn side to get it. Tappy's going up and looking here at these guards, but I'm not sure if there's much.
He must feel that you can't play that shot. He doesn't want to leave it too late where he doesn't have a shot for himself. So,
exactly. So calling the peel here.
We know these young guys. I've seen it across the sheets. They can throw weight.
A little out, but I think he's going to peel them right out of there. Great shot. Oh, unlucky.
A little unfortunate there.
Unlucky there.
But he does have it open, so, I'm sure the Lefort team's going to place a guard, that was his first. What he's going to do.
Unfortunate that was. He made a nice peel. Just those two rocks frozen together like that just drove that back rock right into the house. Good line. Got a little, heavier on the split time here, but with this side curling the way that it does, I'm thinking the weight should come off a little bit more, but they're going to have to bring this one in. A little too heavy for the draw. Evan's going up, and I think he's going to run that stuff in and see what happens. Maybe make a double one way or the other.
Maybe he hits that top one. Not sure about the angle, but that one of the top four might jam over here on the side.
He might. I think he's looking to try to get that 4 foot area open, as you mentioned earlier.
That looked good. No, I think that was a good throw.
They're holding it well, sweeping hard. Just a heavy little break here. What happens?
I got caught in that hard finish you were talking about earlier, Phil.
Yeah.
It's, that rock looked really nice until the last 4 feet or so, and it took a lot of finish. You have to anticipate that, and they'll figure that out. Yeah. So now I think he's thinking that he doesn't want to place that guard again. It's hard with that finish to get that perfect guard, so I think he's a little worried about if he doesn't place it, that the double is actually easier on those two yellows the way they're set up now. You can cleanly double those with no jam, so I'm pretty sure that he's playing the hit back here to sit three, but. We do get caught once in a while where we think we know what they're calling, but the ice for the hit and the draw sometimes can be, it's a hit. Now remember, in the other, going the other way, this broke hard, so.
Yeah, but it's only from the 4 foot line where the break is, and it rides its way down here, and then.
They'll be disappointed with that. It removed that rock, but it didn't force the sit in three, which would have been his preference, would have been to either nose there or have a little roll in.
Sébastien's going to be careful with this ice here. He's right on that 4 foot line starting out, so it'd be important to be straight up the broom here and watch the line call on this one. I think a nose hit mirror makes this.
Makes the W.
Call right away was to sweep. Oh, there's that jump that we saw earlier. Calling hard.
They may have lost it.
They just lost it.
It's a great finish. I know it's disappointing for these players that they're losing some of these rocks, but it makes for a very interesting game to have that strong finish and for teams to have to anticipate that. And usually it means there's a lot of different shots that can be made. Some nice soft shots, and we'll see those, I think, as the game goes on. Everybody's still early in the game and trying to get comfortable.
This is an important shot here for Lefort. He has to stick around here to sit and lie too.
Actually, he could really put a lot of pressure on if he gets a little inside roll. And from where we're sitting, we can't really, I can't quite tell if there's any air there to whether you can get any inside roll. So
I think he's got too much weight. And this side here runs really straight. But I think he's going to hit the high side.
He almost got a double there. So now we've got the opportunity for Team McDonah to just... Inside, actually, if he had hit the rock right where he did the last time, would be ideal. He has to get to the inside in order not to jam on the back one. But it's always a nice feeling when you're going down to the hack, basically playing the same shot you just played in your last rock.
Confirming everything with the sweepers and setting up visualization. Adam not calling for any sweeping. Like he's got nice weight. There's that 4 foot line area. Gonna curl enough. Oh, little outside. Is it gonna come up enough? No, not quite.
He got his one though, so.
No, good throw. I'll take that one, and we're 1-1 here after two ends, and got the jitter ends behind us, and setting up, ready to go.
We'll give you an update on ice four. Manuel got one in the second end, and the first end was a blank, so scores 1-0 Manuel over Abraham. On ice
sheet one,
we had two blanks, so it was score 0-0 Jackson Purcell. It must be a nice temperature out there, Phil. About half of these guys are down to their t-shirts, making me cold just looking at them. So I was looking at the other sheets there. I missed the call. Did Evan call for guard or top four?
I know he's going for the guard.
Okay,
yeah,
great.
Game on. And they just posted the score on sheet two. With Dalton drawing in against one, got his 1 point. We're now 1-1 after two ends of play over there.
Nice weight.
Nice weight, good throw there.
Nice center guard up. And we're going to come around. So Aidan, that's throwing here for Team Lefort. Aiden's been curling for 9 years. And last year he curled with Team Lefort in the under-18 tournament in Bridgewater, the under-21 in St. Andrews, and the provincial under-21 in Sackville. And they won the Schooner Curling Club Cash Bill in April. So, and he He had a good year last year with Team Lefort.
Evan calling for the draw shot. Even though that Lefort rock is in the rings, he's decided to come around, get possession of the 4 foot right now. There's David's second shot at the end. Where's our...
Phil, you must like these socks and the outfit on this Team McDonah.
Yeah, orange, my favorite color. You can't get much more orange than those fellas.
Yeah, they have the socks and everything are in orange.
This one finishing up nice. Reaper's dragging that in. Looks like that's going to finish full eight. Top eight. Good shot.
Get you to keep an eye on the time there, Phil. I feel like those last two rocks may be digging in, but hopefully...
Yeah, I had a split time, 385 on that last one, and I'll get a hog-to-hog here and see what we're running, see if I can get the listening audience a hog-to-hog time here. This is
it's very tight to the guard. And
yeah, knock that one in there mm-hmm. and biter of the 12 foot in the far side there. So I think Evan's going to hit
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I think he'd like to hit that right on the nose and sit right there. Accomplishes two things. It removes the yellow rock and it really puts the center guard back up there. So I see he's taken the intern with quite a bit of ice, so he's playing a fairly quiet weight. Which is good to see. Those high hard ones, they're hard to keep in the rings. Oh, we had a little wobble there. Seemed to recover pretty well.
Good line, great line coming in here, great wage. Oh, great shot, nose hit.
Yeah, well, Alex McDonald would be pretty happy with that considering the wobble he took coming out of the hack. That that worked out perfect.
Yeah.
So now, they're deciding they're going to go for us. We are at second stone, so could choose to play that top one. He's going to play that one in the top 12. Probably hoping to maybe roll over to the
maybe
to the corner.
Maybe a position on that corner guard on the far side. This one really.
Oh, this one's taken off as well.
Once it moves across that 4 foot line, it goes pretty hard.
Oh. Guess we were wrong. We couldn't see between the legs. I thought it was probably going to... that just beautiful.
Having got the nose hit here, I'll line up okay, though. Just confirming on weight here. They're playing that same intern side. Doesn't want any kind of big weight. Just a nice, easy weight, they call it. Something that the sweepers can control.
Well, Alex had a much nicer slide there that time. Nice and steady.
Line looks good. Line looks great. Yeah, great shot, Alex. Nice shot. That was it. Well done. Lefort's going to try the same thing, but only on this side.
Yeah, this is Reece Couture that's throwing... This rock. And Reece has been, is age 17, curling 7 years. So he started at age 10. Last year, Reece was the fifth player for this team and was given the opportunity to join the team when their third moved on to, moved away from Sydney. So that he'll be disappointed with that shot. But, you know, his teammates will have a chat with him. They're chatting with him and help him recover from that and park that one and put it behind you.
Okay, I want to get a split time here, hog to hog. This one here looks like it might be a little light. I'll give you a split time here. Sweeping hard for...
Yeah, I don't think that time's going to tell us there, Philly. The one's going to come up a little light.
1475. I think it's running about 14 from hog to hog would be my 14 and a quarter, I think, would be your hog to hog time. Nicholas is going to come down here and I think he's just trying to hit this one just off nose and try to see if he can get a little better position. On off, that's always a good sign.
Yes, it's a great sign.
That's a good shot.
That is a good shot. We don't have overhead cameras here, so
Alex is going to have to check that out, but I'm still thinking that he's still number one, but I don't think he likes the position of that yellow stone up there. I think he's looking to get a little inside roll behind cover. Calling that's for easy weight again. They have that easy weight Adamus throw line looks okay, although the skip's is holding the line, but just riding that 4 foot line and oh, that's a good shot. Yes, nice little nose hit. Soft,
I don't think
roll.
That's on the rings though, so
I think
you'll see. Think you'll see Team Lefort. Yeah, he's going to call for the 4 foot. It's getting along there in the end, and he'd like to get his deuce here this end. Sweepers are on it, right out of his hand.
I got a 370 for a split time there, so. Oh, this is gonna come up short. Wow. The ice is getting a little stiffer.
Yeah, that's what I was saying at the beginning of this end. I'm kind of wondering. You see the players are chatting a lot, so. Seems a little early for that to happen, but maybe it's.
There's a chance for. Evan really to put some pressure on here, get one buried in here behind cover, a couple of his guards out front, a couple of staggers, put some real pressure here on the Lefort team if he can get this one buried under cover in the 4 foot area.
There's a couple options here. I mean, this is probably the right call. The tap looks a little tempting on the other side, but taps are always a little tricky.
They're always tricky. I remember my old junior coach told me one time, you got to have both the right weight and the right line. Where's the draw weight? You know, typically it's all about weight. .350 on that one for a split time. So we'll soon tell here if the ice is getting a little bit stickier. Sweepers are just dusting it.
Oh, that's back four.
Back 4 foot.
So it's a good opportunity for Team Lefort. Could still get their deuce here. It looks like he's maybe playing the hit. I was thinking that he might just play a draw tap but you know, he's probably with some quiet weight can still get inside nose of this. We'll see what weight he throws, but that ice doesn't look like it's only too quiet. I don't know. I think if I was playing here, that I'd be tempted just to play 4 foot or back 8 weight and
a little softer weight shot. Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly.
Very important to keep your shooter here.
Just holding that 4 foot line there all the way, eh? I think this.
Yeah, that's a hard shot there with that weight since yeah. the 4 foot line hangs, but.
Yeah, just trading the handle back and forth here. I think Evan's got another opportunity, that same line with a little less weight. I think that will tuck right in there nicely behind cover.
I think he probably took an inch or two less ice, yeah.
That ice up a little bit, yes, you're right. While Evan's getting set up here, I do see they now post another score over there on sheet one. You've got Jackson picked up two there. They're in the third end, up 2-0 now, playing in the fourth over there.
Yeah, and a nice four. I just noticed that Team Abraham was heavy on a draw against at two, and so I think Manuel is heading to the hack for an open draw for three.
An open draw for three, or is he got a chance here? Maybe hit that one on the wings of that at the yellow might be a biter over there. I'm not sure. That's Evan
and Evan's got a pretty good shot here. His line's a little tighter, just top eight, and so now they do have to stay because there is a blue rock over on the wings. And so he has to
sitting too, and,
to throw it a little softer this time and get to nose and stick it.
That just didn't finish up for Evan. He threw that real good and just hung out there for a while on that that side of the sheet and just wouldn't finish.
It's all about that 4 foot line. I think if you get inside that 4 foot line, then you get a nice finish.
Are on it.
I think it's looking good. Looking very nice. Very nice indeed. Very that was nice. A great throw. That was a
great pressure shot
and not as easy as it looked. So that was an excellent throw by Sébastien Lefort. On ice four there, we were talking about whether they had an open draw for three or a wings hit to and roll in for a possible four, and they had a timeout, and it looks like the decision was to draw for three, so that rock's on the way, and we'll let you know here in a minute whether Matthew Emanuel gets his three. The sweepers are on it fairly hard, but I think it looks to me like he's going to be fine.
Well, I don't know. They're dragging it.
Yeah, the sweepers really worked hard on that, and the Manuel team did get their three, so the score is 3-1 Manuel over Abraham. So, on our feature sheet, ends on the way here, fourth ends on the way. We call for a center guard. Weight looks excellent. I think they're going to have to start tightening up the ice that they're taking a bit. We just don't seem to be getting quite the swing. Everybody's they're just not quite finishing the way that they were in the first end. And it looks like Team McDonough's calling for a corner guard.
Looking to get some rocks in play. This is the fourth end. This is a scoring end. Those even ends were the ends that you really want to try to take charge of and try to score. They're important opportunities, these even ends. You know, Marion, I would be amiss at this time if I didn't put a special shout out there to my Monday night curling buddies. I know they're back home now in Truro watching the game like we are, so a special shout out to Greg Curry and Dave Murphy, who I know are tuned into the game this afternoon. So special shout out, boys. Hope you're enjoying the game.
Thank you. this is a good looking rock.
Yeah, like
I think they better be careful they don't lose
like
it. Yeah, it looked like it started to dig.
Line, but they're by. Is it got enough weight?
I don't know. That's what I was thinking. They need to be on that just a little bit sooner. They're getting caught a little bit that it's not as slick as it was in the practice in the first couple ends.
I'm noticing the time is coming down a bit. I'm seeing that all across the sheet here, some of the draws and the guards, lots of sweeping going on.
So I think Evan called for top four. Now, Phil, you play with me on Thursday nights. You know what my call would be here. I would not choose to come around those guards with this turn, and just to explain why is that this rock looks like it's not going to be light, but if this rock happens to be light, then they're blocking off their own 4 foot for later in the end. You could play this shot coming the other turn and come around it more as a corner guard. The weight was beautiful.
Great weight.
But now, you know, the other team might be able to get a hit and flop. On the if you had played the out turn side, then if you sat the same thing, they couldn't get an inside roll off that. So that's just a little strategy. It's not that it's a mistake, but it should be a consideration to come the other way. It gives more opportunities when you have the hammer.
Lefort calling for a little inside roll if he can get it. Sweepers are on. No, they're off. Looks like a little inside roll here.
Right, so they're...
Position.
But now, Evan can see about half of that rock. I think he'll probably ask his teammates how much they can see in the hack, and they have that corner guard, so they could get a real nice shot out of this if hits about half of that rock and take a roll behind the corner. It's calling for normal weight, and that's probably a good call, because if he happens to not to have a perfect line, he catches that one, the top of the house, it'll roll away.
Gotta be a little careful here, though. You gotta get something. You gotta make sure you get some damage here, one way or the other.
It's a good looking rock. A lot of weight, so it'll be tough to stay. Yeah. He hit really almost all he could see of that, but it's just with that weight, hard to stay. So Lefort's coming around now. In the case of Lefort, coming with the intern is the right call, because if they come up short, then they are blocking the front.
I see another score posted there on sheet two. The three-ender and the third-end by the Weagle team. So that puts them up 4-1 now after three ends of play. Sweepers are on this. Skip saying no line. They're switching around to try to get the curl. It's going to be
top eight.
I think
it's going to be top eight, and it's not going to be buried.
Open, I think. There's critical time here for Evan and his crew. They got to get some inside roll here to get possession of that 4 foot area. Close that scoring area right down.
It's one of those shots, though, that you could roll either way. So it's important for the skip to make a decision as they see the release and the rock coming down. You know, if there's any outward motion, you could always go
sweeping right away.
As he did.
It's got sort of soft board weight on this. That changes the angle. Nice weight. Just finished a little bit, but the sweepers were on it right away. The skip did call them on it right away, so it might have been a little tight on the release.
So we're up to third rocks, Team Lefort. Nicholas McKenzie in the hack here. Looks like a pretty good throw to me.
Yeah, skip was calling off. Now he's on it.
Oh, falling back a little bit. On that 4 foot line, you get sweepers jump
it. They really held her well.
They did. This is a beautiful shot. That's probably as nice as you can make that shot. That was an excellent shot.
Great, great shot.
Get a little pat in the back from his lead. It's always nice as a player and you make a good shot, have acknowledgement from your teammates, keep everybody positive.
It's a team game, this curling, you know. You have to be positive through the entire game, win, lose, or draw. It's a team sport. Win as a team, lose as a team.
Now this rock looks like it was thrown very well. I think they need to be careful.
Same thing here, they gotta hold that out there.
Yep.
Going hard. Hard to get by. Hard to get by. Oh,
just a nick.
Just rubbed on that high guard.
Yeah, I think the only difference there, Phil, was a pretty good look at both of those releases. They both threw those rocks really well. The difference being waited a little longer for the sweep there. And on that 4 foot line, if you start early, you can hold them. So
early sweep is always critical to hold that rock along that path. Rocks will always finish up, but you can never get them to go back once they start going.
So Team Lefort coming presumably right in here to put some pressure on Team McDonah.
Looks a little short.
Well, that's okay, though. Pro side there is short, and to guard that yellow rock. There's always a pro side to when you're playing this game.
Yep. I worked it okay.
They can still certainly see enough of that rock to hit, but it'll be very tough to save their shooter. And again, just like a couple ends ago, Team McDonough's thinking, is it time to clear some front here so that they have a shot at the 4 foot? Adam's got some weight coming here. It's curling.
Great shot.
That's a good shot.
As I mentioned to you earlier, this even end is a critical time to make sure you score if you can. Even ends are an important aspect of the scoring. So the strategy here was to clear off the front and try to get an opening so that you get a chance to get access to that 4 foot scoring area. Good shot there by Adam.
We're just having quite a little chat here. What would you call here, Phil?
Well, I think they were just wondering position more so than anything, Marion. I think the come around is what he's looking for. And he was recognizing that he's got to try to do something on this side. So doesn't want to throw a guard, but certainly doesn't want to come deep either. So I think he's looking around full eight, top four, partially buried, you know, that sort of Colleen Jones Christmas tree effect, you know, try to get something in there that's partially buried and put some real pressure on.
Slide's nice. Slide looks good, but I thought it looked a little heavy out of his hand. I thought he gave it a little push.
Didn't catch a split time there, but looks to me like this is gliding along here. Back out somewhere for sure. Adam going out to get on that. Working hard. He's working hard to try to get that through. I'm not sure if he got it through or not.
No, I think we still have a biter. So.
Looking at maybe the hit, but got two options. You could try the hit, you could do the draw, but I think he's opted for a
I guess if it was me, I'd be playing this with a quiet weight to make sure that I rolled over to the 12-foot and save the shooter. I think it's key to save the shooter. If he doesn't save a shooter, then he gives Sébastien the same shot to come top four in his last shot. So you would want to stay around so that Team Lefort has to play a hit, and maybe if they, you know, it just opens up more opportunities for your last shot.
Yvon
can't quite see how much ice he's got here, so I'm not sure what weight he's...
It's a tricky spot here again. Remember how that finishes hard off the four-foot line, but it's all about the line starting out.
I'd like to see him just playing board or hack at this.
Looks a little heavy.
Actually, I think it looks pretty nice.
Okay. On that four-foot line now.
No, it's just nice.
Gotta go hard. Breaking hard.
No, they're by the guard, no problem. Oh, my goodness. I was wrong. He did just have hack weight.
Yeah.
And it's got that finish with the hack weight.
Yeah. Tricky spot there.
So now this is a decision. I like where he's tapping his broom for a guard. He wants to bring it in nice and tight. If he brings it in tight, I think if you try to cover the rock in the 8 foot, but a little bit more to the center, and that way you're taking away that draw. You're making that hole pretty small if they choose to draw, and you may force them in to try and. Really tricky double off the one on the intern side on the top 12.
Definitely could put some serious pressure this rock, top 8 foot.
I think you just call Phil for just a bite the 12, yeah, as a guard.
Sweepers are staying a little heavy. Looks pretty good to me.
Yeah, I think though a nose hit's going to give you
just a little heavy.
Those rock placements are always hard. They're critical, and it's hard.
It's a big shot here for Evan.
Now the trick here is that he does have to throw a bit of weight to get enough action for both of those yellows to go, and we know the up weight along this line. Really hang, so it'll be important for him to have a nice release.
Nice release, exactly. Adam calling for the sweep, but as we mentioned earlier, any kind of weight, gotta come up a little more.
It's looking nice. Very nice.
Very nice shot.
So we've got two all after four ends. A nice tight game. I hope everybody out there watching is enjoying it. We're certainly enjoying providing the commentary. Keeping an eye on the other sheets.
Let's go right across the sheets, Marion. Let's start out there with sheet one. I see they posted the score for end number four. And looks like Jackson has stolen three by the looks of that.
It does.
5-0 there after four ends over Purcell. Sheet two, end four is still underway. A few more rocks left to go. And, of course, our feature sheet, 2-2, after four ends. And a couple rocks still left over on sheet four.
Sheet four, though, Manuel is in pretty good position with two rocks buried, and so a lot of pressure on Team Abraham here of how they're going to score. I'm actually trying to look at it here and thinking if I was playing this game, how you could score. Very tricky.
All right, so we're back to our feature sheet here. Team McDonah, Dave McCurdy threw up a center guard, and the Lefort's decided to come around. We were sweeping that all the way from start to finish. Looks a little light, and comes up just a few feet short of the house. Let's see, we're in the fifth end here. I'm going to see if I can get you a good split time.
Looks like quite a bit of ice.
At a 350, right on the nose. Sweeper started on it right away, but they're backing off a little bit. It's a line issue there. I think the weight's going to be awfully close.
A little bit heavy, but I think that was a bit too much ice. I think they need to probably tighten that ice just a little bit. So now Team Lefort's going to come right in. They're going to ignore that blue one. Really, it's they can get one top four and lots of time in the end for that blue one to disappear.
On this one again, right at the start. Line's a whole lot better, but I'm thinking he's a little light again here on the weight, but they're working hard. A little rub on that front guard, and just a little light on that draw. So now Evan's going to work, I think, to the other side, looking for a draw top button. Taking the edge of, just inside edge of 8 foot for the ice. Let's see how this one finishes up.
I'm just reading here that Alex threw the rock. Alex is 16 and been curling 8 years, so he was 8 years old when he started. His weight looks very nice.
Very nice weight. Good line. Tucked in there, a little piece behind the center guards, top 4 foot. Nice shot, Alex.
Alex is quite diverse in his interests. He plays the clarinet and the saxophone, and he also does cross country. And as we know, he curls pretty near every night of the week. Right, this is a very tricky shot here. It's looking nice. Looks like he's got
soft weight.
Yeah.
Sweepers on, sweepers off. That's, I'd say, always a good sign.
That's a very good shot.
That's excellent. Take possession of that 4 foot area. Nice rock. At the
I don't think he could have played that any better. And then Team McDonah has to be careful here as they go to play it, that that they get pretty well to nose, otherwise they're going to jam on that blue one in the back.
Soft weight shot. A little in out on that one, I think, Marion. The thumb slide a little light, a little tight, I mean, and got that out a little bit to try and get back to the room. So that outward motion is always a difficult.
This is actually a good call here. I noticed that Evan's calling for the sweepers to miss that rock. Sometimes it's hard to understand if you watch that why they do that, but he made a decision that if he just ticked it, he would have ticked it perfectly behind all those guards, so he's better off having that left more in the open.
There, he's going to grab the front rock there. He just slid quite tight in there and had a tight release and caught that front guard. Now Evan's going back to the same shot he tried his brother there, and see if Adam can come down here with some soft weight and tap that straight back. Good line, but
yeah.
Just hold.
You don't want to sweep too early there. It just makes it drop back on the line. It's looking very nice.
Just got by.
Oh, Does he have enough weight to remove the rock?
Not sure, but he's certainly set himself up for a good position here with that little roll.
I'm thinking we're going to see a run back here.
Yeah, I'm going to try that run again, I think.
As Nicholas sets up in the hack, just wanted to let everybody know that a couple of interesting things about Nicholas. He has an interest in photography, and he's bilingual. He speaks both English and French.
Sweeping this hard all the way. It's close. Oh, just overcurled a hair on him there. Unlucky.
What's really unlucky about that is now those guards are overlapped, which really is to an advantage of Team McDonah.
Yeah, the stagger of those guards.
Yeah, he's looking at that back blue one, but Phil, if I was playing, I'd be walking right over to that yellow one to play a little hit and roll to the button.
No question, that would be the ideal situation.
I think that's where he's going. Just, it's always good to look at everything. One thing we haven't talked about here today is the time clocks. These games are being timed. Looking across the sheets, they're all managing their time very, very well. Really is not an issue. Just good to see. It can put a lot of pressure on teams if you don't manage your time well and you get down late in the game and you're getting short in time. So now this rock is hanging out. If you're not going to get the inside roll, you want to get an outside roll. But you really don't want to leave that rock right there, because now Team Lefort will use that rock and they'll play the hit and roll in. So that was one of those shots you had to go one way or the other.
Either or, you know.
Yeah, wouldn't have been bad to roll to the 12 foot either. It's always hard to make those decisions. You're thinking that looks like it's coming, and so you're kind of hoping for it, but
this is a critical
this
shot.
This is
here.
A big shot. And Nicholas makes a hit and roll here, and yeah, he's got good line. They call him sweeping. Oh, they get fell back. I think that line is getting ready to take the roll. Well, he got some roll.
Yeah, but now we've moved that rock up a couple of times here now. So I'm not sure from my vantage point here, but I think right now that McDonough's already lying too. So, you know, he could decide to play a guard, but I think he's opting for the nose hit here or a little inside roll. But he has some options. This is a weight critical shot. I've noticed a couple of rocks as they've come in across the hog line, as they're coming in towards the host, there is some finish that it does start to bend. So line call will be pretty critical on this.
So the update from Ice 4, I see they posted the score. Manuel stole one, so score is 4-1 for Manuel and Ice 4. Rock's on the way here. Very nice soft weight they're playing. They're just
very
playing
nice.
Like a hack weight at most.
Oh, he's by that guard. That's the little finish I was talking about. Oh, what a nice little roll. Oh, what a great shot.
Yeah,
that
do you
is.
Notice there, Phil, it gave them the little tap that took away. There always was a draw to the back, 4 foot one, a freeze in there that would have been number one. Timeout, so Team Lefort, this is an important decision time. They take the timeout, their coach can come to the ice, and the coach for Team Lefort is Yvon Lefort.
Each team has two timeouts through the course of the game. Take them at any time. This is a critical, critical time. So they're looking for some discussion. Coach come out, help them out with the thought process as to what the best options are. And
the coach from each team on a timeout, even though this timeout was called by Team Lefort, the coach for Team McDonah can come to the ice level as well. And so I see the mate and skip for Team McDonah is coming to one end, and they'll have a chat with their coach, who's Dave Williams. Dave's been around the coaching world for a long time and coached many great teams. currently coaching Colleen Pinckney's senior ladies team, and coaching for Team Lefort is Yvon Lefort, and I noticed that Yvon is also coaching Team Air, who will be competing for the provincial spot at the provincial Scotties. So
lots
of experience. Yvon has been curling himself for 25 years, and we're not sure how long Dave's been curling, but Dave's been curling a long time himself. And it's wonderful to see all the coaches that are out here today. And the junior teams do require a coach, but wonderful to see some very well-known curlers giving back to their sport and coaching these teams. Couldn't help but notice Paul Fleming here today. He's coaching Team Abraham, and his son's on that team. So what do you think they should call here, Phil?
Well, I'm not sure that they have a lot of options but to peel that front.
Man. Yeah, I think...
I think they've got themselves where the 4 foot scoring area is completely blocked.
There's really no draw. There's no, I think, you know, oh, I think they are trying to maybe, I guess they're going to draw to the 4 foot. And if they get, you could probably get number one there. And if you get in there, like what can Team McDonah do if you get in there? There's no way you could hit. So, I think they've decided it's really late in the end, and with the score 2-2, if you even get a good number two rock in there and you give up one, and you know, he makes a good rock here, I do think you can get number one, and on the other side is still open to draw, so it's his first shot. If he makes a good shot here, he's forcing Team McDonah to think about what to do about it, and he still has his a good open shot for the 4 foot on the outturn side. So I think considering the time and the end, this is a good call. He's going to have to draw on his last rock, and when you're skipping and you have to draw on your last one in a critical situation, it's good to have had a recent draw. So that's probably part of the reason they've decided to call a draw here.
Possibly so. It just looks like he might be a little light on this. That's the unfortunate piece right there, and he has come up short, and so I think he's. He's got that side blocked up pretty good, but looks like Evan might be thinking of coming in here.
Now I have to say I'm surprised about that, because I think the only shot that's left for Team Lefort, from my vantage point, it would be the outturn draw, and I think I'd be stepping up to guard the outturn draw.
They must have had a little chatter about that, I would think, when they had their half of the timeout happening, as to what to do, what if, when. So. I'm thinking this is what they've decided. See if I can grab a split time on this one to see how this shapes up. We know that 350 on this side was back 4 foot, so but a little further out, and sometimes the ice on the outside sheet can be a little bit quicker. He's sliding out, we've got the time here. Got that all. They're running a 370, so maybe they're just playing a straight
guard. No, they're playing a guard.
Yeah.
Adam was up there putting his broom down where they'd like it to stop.
Don't want to set anything up. Well, it's a great guard. No tap there at all. So, and he's forcing his hand for a cold, hard draw to the edge of the 4 foot line, looking against three. Taking the edge of 8 foot for ice.
A lot of pressure on the sweepers here. This is a shot where it's be made as much by the sweepers as it will be by the thrower. They look very intent. The sweepers are really focused, got their watches ready to go. I notice they're both timing. I always like when one person's timing and one person's watching. Watch them release. It's looking very nice.
On and off. Sweeping hard now, though. Sweep hard. Hard for sweep. Hard, hard, hard.
That's disappointing. His line was absolutely perfect.
Great line.
Very disappointing. I think
looks like a
couple more feet he'd had a point here. So I think we have a steal of three. Place the score up here. Yeah, score
yes,
is 5-2 for McDonough over Team Lefort. So fifth end, they're going to take a break. We'll keep you posted on the other games.
So we look across the sheet here. We'll see here. No score posted there on sheet one after five. We'll give you the update on that one. But looking here on sheet two, Dalton picked up one in the fifth end. So after five ends, it's Weagle 5 and Dalton 2. As we sit on our feature sheet here, a big steal of three there by the McDonah team. Puts them up 5-2 after five ends of play. And fifth end is still shaping up here with the Manuel Abraham game, and we'll keep you a live posting here once the last rocks are thrown. First skip stone there for the Manuel team. He's got one back button, the center guard just thrown, and a couple of other yellow stones kicking around the outside edges. So Abraham team in a little bit of trouble here in the fifth end.
So we're back here with you, folks. Just took a little break. Just thought at this time it'd be nice to let everybody know some of the local sponsors that have provided their sponsorship to this event. The A&W in Amherst, McDonald's Restaurants in Amherst and Sackville, Duncan's Pub and Eatery, Victoria Street, Amherst. But on these events, it's important to have the support of local sponsors. And looking around this club, it looks like they have very strong sponsorship in general for the club. And nice of these local sponsors to step up and do this additional sponsorship for this event. The Nova Scotia Curling Association has sponsors and partners as well that we'd like to acknowledge. TV One, the Weston Group, which the Comfort Inn is a member of, PWC, Health and Wellness, Kruger Support for Sport, Sport Nova Scotia, Jet Ice, and Travelers. It's really, we're very thankful to all the generous sponsorships that curling has, and partnerships, I like to call them, more than sponsorship. And I know as a longtime curler, we like to do our best to support our sponsors when we can. So it looks like the action's going to get back underway here. The teams are back on the ice and ready to go. The break, interesting time for a break. You get a chance to get off the ice, have a chat with your coach, grab a snack. And as I always say, this that break was perfect timing for Team Lefort when you're down a little bit. It's nice to break the momentum for Team McDonah. They were probably wishing there wasn't a break. You like to keep going and keep that momentum. So it'll be interesting to see how the next end goes. And I've seen, being on many teams that were down, how the break has played to your advantage. So see if Team Lefort might have a little stronger end. Really played quite well in the last end. It was really just a matter of inches here and there, and certainly just a little bit on the weight side. Sébastien hadn't been drawn too much, and I do think the ice is it's a tad heavier than earlier in the game, and so that can make it quite tricky when you're up against a three there for a draw. This looks like it might be a little bit heavy. That can happen sometimes when they give it a fresh sweep in this fifth end break. Sometimes it's a little bit like a polish, so the very beginning of the sixth end can be just a little bit quicker. So, interesting here, Team McDonah had wished to keep this end clean and simple, and the first rock came up light, so now he's having the lead remove his rock. That may seem strange to anyone that doesn't play the game, but when you have a three-point lead, that guard wasn't really in their favor. That's unfortunate. I thought that David threw that quite well. It was coming up nicely, did get a little piece of rock, and really at that weight only needed to get another inch or two and would have made that peel. So Team Lefort's coming in again. Changed the turn here, which I find kind of interesting. I can understand because of the placement of the rocks, but the lead just threw the other turn, and we might give him exactly the same shot. Sweepers are on this one. The last one, they didn't touch. This one looks very nice to me. It's
1460 from hog to hog. So
they dug right in there. But that's a splittable rock later in the end. So it was important that last little sweep when the skip went out and this, kept going. Always important to get those guards when you have last rock as tight as you can. You might have the opportunity to split that on for an extra point.
Evan going back to that strategy, keeping this house clean as he can. Up three.
I'm not sure if he can pick that a double out of that or whether he's just playing the straight peel.
Get that a little bit out, but he's going to get that front guard. I think you'll see them throwing some pretty big weight the next little bit, trying to keep things cleaned up.
So Sebastian's decided here to split the house to not cluster the rocks, increase the chances of some doubles. He's called for the 12-foot, and I think that's good. He's focused on a deuce, and you don't have to get your 3 points back in this one end. They got their deuce on this end. that would boost their confidence considerably. And then you force the other team to take one, and you get a deuce the next time, and you're all square again. This rock looks like it's a T-line or better.
Grinding in there. T-line, yeah. That's a good shot. Evan's going to look for the double here. One thing that's critical about these double takeout shots is that you still want to have some control weight. You start throwing the weight too high. Sometimes that harder weight, difficult to keep on the broom.
I stepped away there and took a little break. Phil, did you give everybody an update the scores at the end of the fifth end break?
There was a couple sheets that weren't posted yet, so we probably should review that and give
everybody. This rock is curling, and yeah, it's going to stay there. That was important.
All right, we'll go across the sheets here then. So on sheet one, fifth end, the personal team got 2. So let's score 5-2 after 5 ends for Jackson. On sheet two, we mentioned that the Dalton team picked up 1 there in the fifth, so that is Weagle 5, Dalton 2 after 5 ends. Of course, our feature sheet, 5-2 for McDonough after 5, and there was a steal there on sheet 4. The manual team did steal 1, so now they're up 5-1 after 5 ends of play over there.
So on our feature team, I see the hit. We're going to lose our shooter there. And so did you notice anything about those scores, Phil? Five-two, 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 five-one.
Five's the number after 5.
So Team McDonough's having a discussion here whether they try to run a run back double to clear both yellows. And, you know, that's the way they've been playing this end, so it's probably the right idea to stay with that strategy at this point. It's close. It's really close. Really close. Great shot. That was a great shot. So, you know, it does leave a guard out there. So from Team Lefort's standpoint, you know, they have hammer and corner guards are good, so they'll not be too upset about that. They'll just step up and get a good one around this corner guard. Now, we haven't been playing with the corner guards very much. Remember in practice here, Phil, this is where we saw the biggest swing. He's got ice just outside the button, I think. It's hard to see from our vantage point, but we saw in practice is once it hits this center line, it was quite a good finish. So.
Yeah, most of our play has been from the outside.
It has.
In, but... this is a little heavy, this one here.
But even with it being a little heavy, you can see there that that's got some nice finish. So
yeah.
If that had had a little less weight on it, I think that was the perfect call for line.
No question. It was a good line call, just a little heavy on the weight.
Well, the key here is that they want to get rid of this yellow, but... I'd like to see them not play with too much weight and keep this rock in play. If you give the other team the exact same draw, they'll probably make it good the next time.
Got to make sure here. Sweeping hard to get by. Coming close to that corner guard. Whew. Hit and rolled out.
And he got by that guard as close as he could. So the only way you could have stayed there was to play a quiet weight.
I think Lefort's going right back to that same strategy again, wanting to get that buried this time, front of the tee line.
And it's Nicholas McKenzie throwing the rock again, so he knows that line is good. Trust that broom. The line is really good.
Sweepers
they better
indicating.
Watch they don't lose this. It's line's really good this time.
Was indicating a little heavy, but like you said, that's going to be tight to that guard. Going out to try to get that one through with a little sweeping.
Yes, and it's through.
Just through the house.
That's
unlucky
too bad.
I feel bad
for Nicholas. Threw that really nice.
It's a little heavy.
So, staying with the strategy that they've been playing since the beginning of this end, he's going to peel that guard out. You know, he had an option here. He could come around it himself and place it nice, but, you know, obviously they had a discussion with their coach at the break and decided that keeping this clean, and this may allow the other team to blank the end, but they probably prefer that the other team blanks than has the opportunity for the deuce.
Really, with this strategy here, there's no opportunity for a two-point end. If they can make this go away, they just clean her up. This one here looks like it's
yes,
going
it
up.
Looks like it's. So Sébastien will be looking to come around that now. A little bit different line. Yeah, I was going to say. He knows the eye. He didn't hesitate for even a second about where to place that broom. So it tells you that I think he has a good feel for the line. It's always a great thing when the skip has a really good feel for the line, and they can just put all their energy and focus into the weight. Trust the broom. Yeah. He asked for a couple more inches of less inches of ice in the hack.
Less ice there, yeah,
yeah,
the hack,
sort of
so.
A dangerous thing, as we know, to do from the hack, to change your ice.
It's pretty well in the room, but I'm thinking this is going to overcurl on them. It's coming up really hard on that guard.
So there's a lesson for everybody. You trust your ice, and you get in the hack. Sometimes it looks a little different from the hack, but you should trust the ice you gave yourself. And unless, you know, sometimes you go down and the front end will say to you, are you sure about that ice? Remember this rock or that rock? If you've received some intelligence down at the hack that tells you that maybe your broom is wrong, but if it's just a visual that's telling you that maybe it's not the right broom, most times you've given yourself the right ice. Because his weight looked real nice there, Phil. And
yeah, he had great weight. Good split time there for T-line. And it just the sweepers couldn't hold it there with the way that comes off the center line so hard to the wings. I see Evan's got quite a bit of ice here. I mean, the secret to this shot is making sure you're not too tight to that opponent's guard. I mean, getting in buried behind cover is ideal. But even if he's partially, he'll put the force on here and putting a force on and getting the hammer back, being up a couple, be a great position to be leading into the back half of this game. Sweepers on that a little bit.
Yeah, lots of room though. Line's not an issue.
Line's not an issue. Line's actually good now. They just got to work hard to get it there. They're sweeping hard.
He's coming up short.
A little short.
So this is going to be a throw-through for a blank end. He'll scoot down the ice quickly, not lose any time. Presumably that he's going to blank. I suppose we shouldn't presume that. There are people that feel strongly about scoring in the even ends. I have seen teams choose to take a point. He's having a little look to see if... front rock for sure wasn't in. And it's a throw through. Well, we just overheard somebody saying that the game on ice one might be over. So in our feature game, the score remains at 5-2, and Team Lefort retains a hammer and 7. And indeed, that game on ice one is over. I'm not sure what happened in the score, but Team Jackson, victorious over Team Purcell. So I'm sure David is making sure that he gets in the house with this one this time. On the pro side here from his skip standpoint was if he's heavy, which looks like he is a little bit heavy, that's the preference over being a little light.
So Lefort's going to go back to the same sort of strategy, getting a corner guard up, working his way to the outside sides of the sheet, trying to get a couple of guards in play to get some rocks buried behind cover. Got to put some pressure on this McDonah team and try to get a deuce here. And
Team Lefort, playing together for 6 years, they first started preparing and competing, hoping to get a berth in the 2015 Canada Winter Games. While they didn't represent Nova Scotia at the Canada Games, it certainly was a building opportunity for them. The opportunities that trying to secure that berth gives young teams is tremendous, and gave them that taste for competitive curling, which obviously they enjoyed and are now moving into competing in the under 21s, and they can compete in the under 18s. All under the age of 18, so they'll be competing in that as well, I'm sure.
And that's a good shot here coming in by Al McCurdy, getting two rocks in play, forcing the play into the house now. And if they get an opportunity with a hit and roll out, they'll definitely step up there and try to peel that corner guard off.
So I'm presuming the call here is to a little hit and roll off this.
Not really. He's throwing another corner guard.
He's throwing another corner guard up. Okay.
A little early. Yeah, he's trying to get himself set up here for getting something to set up to get behind cover.
I was sneaking a peek at a couple other sheets there. Missed that call.
There's your two corner guards. That's what he was looking for. So now Evan's going to start.
You go for that higher guard. It might be a double off that. He's going to throw some peel weight. So these young guys love the opportunity to throw that peel weight.
All for the sweep right away.
Yeah, I think he's got
like
a nose.
Nose hit here. All right, there's the opportunity that Lefort was looking for.
Yeah, now he can get a nice play that top blue one and get a lovely roll behind the yellow corner guard.
I think that's the call, Marion. You're right on.
Just notice in the clocks, Team Lefort still has over 17 minutes to play the remaining four ends, and Team McDonough's got 16 minutes, so they're managing their time really well. I'm really happy to see that. Oh dear, this is curling on them.
Yeah, he's
you get that started a little bit.
That intern, he's having a little bit of trouble getting to the broom, and then he gets it started a bit, and it does overcurl hard on him. So something to work on there on that one.
At least he was able to pick that blue one, make him feel a little bit better that they eliminated a blue rock, because that had to go sometime.
Evan's going to go up and remove that corner guard nearest to the house, his opponent's rock. Call for sweep right away. Uh-oh, it's holding there. It's got to curl up a bit more. It's got to get across that 4 foot line.
Yeah, that's good.
Nice shot.
So Alex redeemed himself there. He'll feel a little better after missing the first peel to make the second one.
So an interesting call here, Marion. He's calling for the hit and roll.
Yeah, I think I might ignore that rock.
Yeah, me too. I think I'd be more tempted to get position with the draw coming around there. And
particularly when you just had this player had a little struggle in this spot, it might have been good to give him the draw. That said, if he makes this, he'll forget about the first one, and be careful they don't lose this. It comes hard from the hog line in. Nope, stayed right there. Threw that one really nice.
Yeah, good throw. And again, critically important here for the McDonah team too, with Adam throwing this one to make sure you stick around. You know, you hit and roll out here, then you put the opportunity right back to the other team to draw around that corner guard. So he does have some nice weight at this here, nice controlled weight. Sweepers can hold it.
Yeah, he's not interested in rolling anywhere near that corner guard. He wants to roll away.
Nice,
yeah, it's a good shot. I see there's some scores posted on the sixth then. On sheet four, Team Abraham picked up two. So score is 5-3, Team Manuel over Team Abraham. And on ice two, who's throwing Blue Rocks
Wiggle
there? Yeah, Team Wiggle
yeah.
is up 6-2 on Team Dalton. I like these teams that have the names on the back of their jackets. It makes it easier for those of us that don't know some of these teams very well. One thing, Phil, I'd like to mention, you know, eight young men's teams out here. I've seen tremendous displays of sportsmanship today. I haven't seen any broom banging or any...
Very well coached.
Yeah.
It's great to see.
It is good. I think that's...
Curling such a game of etiquette. You know, we like the tradition that curling has with those long-standing rules, and it's great to see the sportsmanship, and it's good to see.
So just trading rocks here until somebody gets the roll. Team McDonough not wanting the roll, and
they're working hard
Team
to
Lefort
hold that on
the roll.
Line, and what a great
sweep
it's
just
going to
be
Oh.
They might have they wanted that roll a bit too much, so that's a little bit of a miss there. The rocks are the provincial rocks the players are using here, and they are a little more lively sometimes than we're used to in some of the club play, where that probably in the home club there, the McDonough team would not have lost that rock. So that's something that players have to get used to with these rocks and realizing how they react. So that got a lot of action for how much the rock he hit. So now a great opportunity for Team Lefort. They're going to draw around that corner guard. They put these corner guards up for a reason, and the opportunity is presenting itself.
A little short here, I think, Marion.
Well, the pro side, though, is that now he's got a double corner, and Team McDonough's got a decision to make. Can they double those corners? Yep, I think there's a quarter rock or so, and everything will go.
Yep, it's anywhere, you know, third or so on that high side should clean her up. But you have to be a little careful here and make sure that you make that top one go away for sure.
Yeah, certainly that's the most dangerous guard now with them being staggered. Gives a lot of opportunity to get by that and get nicely buried. The blue one's a little tighter to the house and a little harder to get buried around. Oh.
Well, looks like Evan was a little wide on this one.
Yeah, I think we're going to have a miss.
Yeah, I got that one started on the outside and just
down that center line just
down
runs.
The center line, yeah, didn't get to the broom on that one. So a real opportunity here now for Lefort to get buried in behind cover and put some pressure square on the shoulders of McDonough.
Sébastien Lefort started curling at age 6 and a half. What a tremendous time to start curling. You can tell he knows the game really well for 16 years of age. And Interesting fact about this team as well is the third and the skip have been friends since primary. So, you know, as we know and have talked about before, having that kind of trust in your teammates and that goes a long way in this sport. So nice to see friends playing together. Nice to see on Team McDonough brothers playing together. Now, from our vantage point, I can't see if that's on. We're having a close look. And I think it must have got a bite.
Yeah, be better. Evan's hitting that. So the only other thing that if it's not on, Evan might think it's close enough to be able to split.
Split, so yeah. So I think on think or off is this the right call. If he could hit just three-quarters of the rock, he might get a little roll onto the 12-foot
himself. Three-quarters on the high side, for sure. You know, would roll into that 12-foot area and force them to try to make the peel shot to keep the hammer going to the next end. But I think the key here for Evan, just because he missed his last shot, he has to reload here and make sure he throws this clean and nice, easy control weight that sweepers can work with. Important to make this rock go away. That looks like a little better weight than he had on the first one.
He's riding there, though. I don't know if it's going to come up enough for him.
Uh-oh. Don't want to bump this in. Uh-oh. Oh, looks like...
So we got an open draw for two for Sébastien. Yeah, I think I actually thought he threw that pretty good. It might have been just a bit too much ice, maybe worry too much about that roll. Like sometimes we worry about getting that roll on versus making that go away. Interesting point about Sébastien is that he loves to write, and he's written two short stories that have been published in two different books, Winds of Change and In the Skies. One of the stories played third in the grade 7 category throughout all of Canada. That's wonderful to see people with such balanced lives where he can be creative like that and play sports and very well-rounded. The sweepers are staying off this one. They thought for a second they might. And it's just coming in there nice. I think they want to sweep it, but that very nice back four. So there's that two that, yeah, the skips deuce.
Skips deuce, just a little inopportune there on the McDonough side, and then give an opportunity for Lefort to get his deuce. So
it's important for Team McDonough, and particularly Evan, not to get a little down about that. So we're moving into the eighth end. Scores 5-4. I'm sure that Sebastian's going to call for a guard and keep trying to put some pressure on. Yep. Get a time here sometime soon, Phil, to see what the ice is running as we're getting late in the game.
Yeah, for sure. Let's see if we get a split time here.
See a nice four. They got an interesting end going, and they're taking a timeout. Coach is out on the ice.
That's a 394, so it will be interesting to see where that ends up. I'm thinking that...
needs to curl, or it's going to be more of a corner guard, which will be advantage of McDonough.
Tight guard.
Yeah.
It's not too bad.
Yeah, that ran along kind of nicely, actually. So we're calling for another corner. Just good looking wait for the guard. And you might notice that Evan is standing out where he'd like that rock to stop, and doing a little bit of skipping myself. I find that's very helpful to the sweepers. It keeps the skip more engaged as well, to be showing the players exactly where they want the rock to stop, and helps the sweepers to get some more, a little bit more of a visual as they're coming close to the house. This rock is curling. Not sure it's going to have enough weight
really breaking off that center line. But, you know, a couple of
That's not a bad shot. I mean, they were calling for it to be a little bit deeper than that. But I think, you know, again, pro side.
I think Evan's changing his strategy here to go back to the draw game.
Well, David's had tremendous draw weight this game. So you have to play to your player's strength as well. So lots of room. Yeah, that's way out there, and I think if it's...
Looks a little heavy to me.
I was going
to
say, it must be heavy if it's riding out there. I think we just jinxed them. Might have been the announcer's curse saying that he had... having a nice draw weight. So, unfortunately, that slid through. We're just hearing that the game on ice two is over. So, that'd be Team Wiggle. Victoria's over Team Dalton. Okay, so this looks like it's curling as well. Is it going to get by that center guard?
They're working it hard. Holding that 4 foot line, but does it have the weight? That's the question. They're by the guard.
By the guard. Lovely line if they can keep at it.
The 12 foot for sure, maybe even a piece of the 8. Just full 12.
You can see about
three quarters, maybe.
Maybe.
No more, two thirds probably.
He's calling for quiet weight though with that broom.
Sweeping it. You're on it hard. Bye by lots.
I'm hearing them say on ice four, the game next to us is having another timeout. So that's two timeouts in the same end. It's a tight game, a lot of rocks in play. So they're having a slow end and the coach is out in the ice.
Pretty critical time of the
game.
Yeah,
it's very critical.
All right, back on our feature sheet here, calling for the intern come around. Line was pretty good, but I'm thinking the weight's just a little up again, but sweepers are on it a little.
No, I think it's going to be back 8.
It's gliding here a bit, isn't it? Back 8 it is, look at that, and wide open, but Evan's got some thinking.
He's got hammer, so it would seem like the right thing to get top 4 here.
Yeah. Again, an important call. Line looks a little tight. The sweepers are on it, but they've held it out there. Still riding the 4 foot line. But they have the weight. It's got perfect line if it's got the weight. Easy, easy. Don't want that too far. Oh, there's a nice shot.
I think, though, that
It's tough to get the curl.
It is tough. It is tough to get that finish.
You know, if they even play some backline weight on that.
Looks like that's
what it's above the T-line, which is always critical. Keep possession of that that scoring area around the button.
It's a good-looking throw.
Looks like it's taken
off. Oh, it's taken off, yeah, out of his hand. I do think that may have picked on him.
I believe so. Looked like that just grabbed.
I had a good look at his, maybe, but it was light as well, so I suppose it might have been because light, but it was right up the stick, I felt, when he let it go.
It just seemed like it really started going hard, so it must have been the weight. Evan's got a decision to make here, and I think the right call is waiting on top of your stone again.
He's thinking about going around that corner guard, Phil, but if you ever end up top 12, he could set them up for a double. I think the right call here is just come right in on top of the one you just threw. Yeah, time. I was just thinking that I didn't want to say that, but I was thinking that, you know, it could be a good time for a timeout. It is the eighth end.
It's a critical time, and as I mentioned earlier in the broadcast, the even ends are such a critical time to be in possession of scoring. So I'm
going to predict that Dave Williams is going to come out here and talk these boys into calling to come right in on top of that blue one.
Yeah, I definitely would agree. I would say, you know, you come down and you weld on top of that. A great opportunity to get your two and.
Yep, he's fist pumping the boys. That discussion didn't take long, and which is great too. I think keep their confidence high. Don't talk about it too long. And he's giving Evan a little pat in the back. And
yeah, definitely. You're right, Marion. Right on the nose is the call. You want to come right down on top, freeze right on there, and right on the money on your call. Line looks good if they can
hold her. Line looks very good, but I think the weight's a little light.
Line by,
yeah, no, the line's great.
All sweepers,
line's
now.
Really good.
It's all
look
sweepers.
At that.
Oh,
good looking
what a great
shot.
Curling shot. What a great curling shot that is.
That's a very nice shot.
Nice throw there by Adam.
What I like the most about that, Phil, is not only did he get in there, but he got that little curl where there's no double.
Got
he had stayed
stagger.
There a little bit, yeah.
Now
the front. And this is what Team Lefort would have discussed during their timeout. They wouldn't have been worried about what Team McDonah was doing. They would have been playing one shot ahead. And, you know, they stepped up here very quick with this call. So I think that had been decided in their timeout. Regardless of what happened, it was time to clear the front to leave Sébastien a shot as last rock.
They cleared off that high guard, but...
I think they were hoping for a double. I think they were hoping. And they came close to picking that... And, of course, you know, from Team McDonough's standpoint, if Team Lefort didn't like that rock out there, then you should just put that rock right back out there. I see we have an updated score on ice 4. Looks like Team Manuel has picked up 3 and now leads that game 8-3.
Call for that center guard, and Sluba's working hard. Line looks great. Trying to close off that port a little bit.
Yeah, I don't think there's a port there. If there's a port, it's going the wrong way, so you can't come through it. I should say that. I guess you could, but you probably would jam the second one, but.
Probably going to give it a go.
Yeah, you can't really, because you're going to take something if you get through the port.
Case,
yeah,
get something off the front there, but he's got to do something, because McDonah has that scoring area locked up solid right now.
We might be losing. It's with all these rocks, it is Team McDonah that has hammer here. So if he ever got through this, and even if he nosed it and stuck the top one, he'd be number 2 and 3, and he could live with McDonough only getting one this end. So not taking much ice, so I think this is going to be coming with a little bit of heat. I think he's going to get through this hole, Phil.
It's close.
It's very close. Oh, that was very
just
close.
Just caught on the front blue one. Super close.
It's always disappointing, because you always want to see how that was going to end up if he'd gotten through that hole, and what action he was going to get on those rocks. So
Evan's taking a little less ice, just trying to tighten that up a little bit, not giving that opportunity. And
well, do you think he's calling to come in? Because
I thought the call was a short guard, but you're right. You know, if you ever come down in the same thing that Adam did and lie three, boy, that would be a ton of pressure on the opposition.
But you got to be careful sometimes when you do that. You could set up a triple. So
yeah.
I expect he's just playing the guard in a similar place that he did the last time. Then it was decision time for Team Lefort. Do they, line's tight on this one.
Sure was.
Line's really tight.
Hard to get this over.
Yeah, I'm not really talking. I'm busy watching whether they're going to get it over.
Big sweep.
So
left that exposed. So I'm thinking with the right kind of weight, he might be able to get both of these.
I was hoping they were going to call down to the other end, ask them how much they could see from the hack so we'd know how much they could see. But sit in the hack and see if he likes the look of this. Sometimes looks quite different from the hack than it does when you're calling it from the house end.
It's asking to get for a bit more ice, you know, that's always sometimes a scary situation, but here it comes. Started sweeping right away. Now they're off. It looks like it's floating out. Oh, that extra weight and that extra couple of inches of ice, I think he's...
He's going to get one of them.
He's got to get enough to move it, though.
Oh,
did he move it far enough? Appears to be.
Yeah, I think it's a draw for two.
You know, have you ever played that with T-line weight for the sweepers, and you had the good line, you could always sweep that a little extra and try to get to the back of the house and get that little bump. But
yeah, I think based on the ice he's taking, that's probably the shot he's playing.
I think so. Got to be a little careful here, not to throw it trying to make the shot. You want to use your sweepers here on this one.
Yeah, there's a tendency a lot of people think they need back line to weight and then you might not get the curl, so
because
the deuce is really if you're Team McDonah, I think that you know the deuce is enough for in this end at this stage in the game. The three is nice, but you don't want to make a mistake and end up with just one.
A 360 split, so that should just be T line just barely. So I think they're gonna sweep all that everything they got. I think this is gonna be short. Unlucky.
Well, I think that's just one for Team McDonah. The team needs to go up now from just team dynamics. It'd be important for the team to go up and have a little chat with Evan. He'll be disappointed after that and give him a little support and see eight then. They're still up two. Team Lefort will be feeling confident about how that end went for them and ready to get back at it. Nine. Keep putting the pressure on.
Still in control, up to after eight ends is a good place to be. Got to stay focused, execute, work on the details, and that'll work out fine. So Lefort, now they got to put a little pressure and start to get those corner guards up for this end and work hard at getting another deuce.
So Well, the call was for in the house, and this rock will come to rest top eight, half of the eight, half of the 12th. And the team Lefort will put up the corner guards. Working hard to get this over.
That's a good position.
The skipper comes out to give a little help. One thing I like, I see they do when the skip does come out here, there's no value in having three people sweeping. And when the skip comes out, the other players step aside and they've got a fresh sweeper and they let the skip finish that sweep. Sometimes teams like to stay there, but if the skip's coming in, you might as well let them right in by the rock and a nice fresh sweep.
McDonah calling for another one in the house. It looks like it's a little heavier than the first.
That's good.
Repeat strategy there for Lefort here now in the ninth, getting his two corner guards up.
And it worked good for him in the seventh. He got his deuce in seven, and this is how the end started out. He ignored the rocks in the house and put up his corner guards. And we have a final, a nice four as well. So Team Manuel won that game. So the only game left on the ice is our feature game.
So Marian, tell me a bit how this might change the dynamics a little, where you know, now it's going to be only one team out on the ice. It's a bit quieter, you know, less noise out there. Does that impact you as a player to think differently?
Yeah, it certainly does. If you're not used to that, it can be a little bit eerie. Now, knowing these teams, and they practice a lot, and I expect that they practice as a team. So it's good when you practice as a team on the weekend. You're out here by yourself. You can get that feeling of being the only players out on the ice. But for sure, the ice can change as well. It may start stiffening up a little bit, so you have to watch that. It's late in the game anyway, and so you get ice changes, but certainly losing all that body heat out on the ice will increase the chances that the ice will change. So everybody needs to be a little bit sharper and just stay focused, because the quiet sometimes can just take you out of it a little bit. Takes the energy down, so you have to find the energy by, you know, talking lots to your teammates. And, of course, where we are, we can't really tell how well they're communicating, but these guys have been coached well to do lots of communication.
I see Evan changed his strategy there, went to a different
he
plan.
Did.
Instead of peeling those center guards, he put up a center guard, and Lefort tried the run back, and he ended up, unfortunately, bang, bang, bang. So now Evan's got two in the house, and calling for another guard up front.
I expect this is something they've discussed with their coach, at what point you you make that switch. And also you're watching how your players are playing and how they're feeling about the various shots. Now this is out there. I'm not sure we're going to get Curl over to where he wants it to be, but if you're quick and watch it, and I think this is what he's doing, he's trying to use the yellow rock to serve the same purpose, to do a little jiggle in there and cover that blue rock.
Worked out pretty good, actually.
He did, and it was good to see how sharp he was, to see that that rock was hanging out there and that he had to kind of go to a plan, a little bit of a plan B.
Evan recognized that right out of as he threw it. He got that just a little bit outside, and they utilized sweeping, and turned out to work out good.
Plan B's are okay. It's when it's Plan Z that it's not good.
Yeah, we call that Plan Q on our team. So again, trying to run this yellow back into the pile, but they're holding it. They're holding
they
it.
Are. This looks pretty good, actually, Phil. Caught that
top blue one.
Yeah, that's still a really good shot, though. I mean, they're
okay.
And they kept their corner guard. So I'm not sure I agree with guard in this one, but for me, it looks really tempting to come with the intern and Christmas tree that rock, but that might not be a good idea either. You might leave them a hit and roll behind the corner.
Key here is all about the line, and it's got a cross center, and I'm not sure, I haven't seen anything work hard across the center line. Sweepers aren't touching
line,
it.
The line looks fine, it's just...
trying to work hard for a little rub here, I think.
Weight was perfect.
Weight was good, yes it was. I can still see a pretty good piece of that one in the forefoot, and...
he's calling the hit and maybe stay there. If it hangs a little bit, you could roll behind your own corner. Be a good shot as well.
Seen lots of rocks come down this side of the sheet, so they should have a good read on the ice. Sweeper's on it a little bit. Now the skip's called them off. He's waiting for it to finish. It's going to come off that 4 foot line. Got to curl a little more for him. Oh gosh, that was awfully close. He threw that really well.
He did throw that well. Just like to kind of quickly review the local sponsors and Nova Scotia Curling Association sponsors for this event. Local sponsors include A&W in Amherst, McDonald's Restaurants in Amherst and Sackville, and Duncan's Pub and Eater in Victoria Street, Amherst. I'd like to thank those local sponsors for supporting this event and their local club. The Nova Scotia Curling Association has sponsors in TV1, the Weston Group, including Comfort Inn, PWC, Health and Wellness, Cougars Support for Sport, Sport Nova Scotia, Jet Ice, and Travelers. This is a nice looking rock, Phil. Line looks really nice.
Weight looks good. Sweepers are on and off a little bit.
Needs to come up just a little bit.
Trying to get
it. Very nice
looking
shot.
That's a good throw by Adam.
And
there's your half buried that you were talking about earlier, just to kind of get partially in there and block that scoring area.
We're at third stones here in the ninth end.
Some pretty good weight on this one. I
think it's going to hang out. I think it may just ride that line.
It's a little out on that one. Yeah, just a little outward movement. Just run that 4 foot line all the way down.
When you have that little extra up weight.
Yeah, we talked about that earlier in our broadcast, thinking that you get that little extra weight, it sure can ride along the line there. And just that little extra weight that made the difference.
So those guards are staggered out front, so I think the key here for Team McDonah is not to come too tight with this guard. If you come real tight with this guard, they'll use your guard to run into the pile. I think this guard should be no more than halfway.
Yeah, I think he'd like this anywhere on that 4 foot line from the hog line to halfway point. Yeah. Would be ideal.
Noticing the clocks, Team McDonough has got 7 minutes left. Skip rocks on the ninth end, so they're managing their time well. And Team Lefort still got 10 minutes on the clock. I'm We should thank all the volunteers that are supporting this event as well, and timers. It's a job both Phil and I have done. It takes a lot of concentration and focus, and it's important to the players that it's an important part of the game. So thanks to all the volunteers that are helping with that. And that was a well-placed guard.
It's a perfect position. He's got that whole side covered up, and really
time
not
out.
Much of an opportunity there.
Team Lefort called a timeout. Yep.
Timeout on three there, Steve.
So I don't know. Not sure what the coach's advice is going to be to them. There's the yellow on the yellow corner guard there, Phil. I'm wondering if it's lined up to the other yellow. It's not a shot you'd like in your.
Well, there's two schools here, really. You've got the option of trying to peel a bunch off the center somehow, some way to get any opportunity to get at the scoring area. The other option is utilizing, you know, one of your angle shots, but that does create some risk, because it's more like a do or die situation at taking on that. But risk versus reward. If you make one of those, you can turn the end or right around. But
I don't see an easy double peel. If you look at the yellow blue on the center line, if you could double them off, that would be a nice big port. But you can't double them off because of the corner guard that was just placed. I think they're going to play the blue.
I think maybe they're looking at this option of this double peel, and maybe expecting that the object stone that they're shooting at might come off of that center line blue one and twist back around and catch that yellow one that's just near the top of the 12-foot area, and it might bounce that into the house.
Or if it doesn't do that, the other thing that here is you open this, they'll probably place one guard, but you'll open up a yellow that can be used as a raise.
Exactly.
So,
like they're looking at somehow getting another option for a second shot.
Yeah.
This is the
right call from what I can see. It's looking good, I think. Or too thin?
Just a little thin, I think. Oh. Yeah, just had to hit that more like
He did still
seven,
open,
eight.
Though. You can't block both yellows, so there's one shot left to come, and they'll choose to guard one of them. And I think he did at least the move the blue rocks so that the blue is not overlapping any yellow. And presumably they're going to guard the one on the outturn side, which to me looks like the easiest tap. There will still be a tap on the one on the intern side as well. Not ideal for Team Lefort, but still an opportunity.
Certainly a good placed guard here will make it a real challenging and difficult situation for the young Lefort skip. Key thing here is not to set this up. Sometimes
you can set that up and...
Well, that's a good shot. You really couldn't place that a whole lot better. I mean, he's still got that sort of double raise, but difficult shot nonetheless. Or that straight run back to try to make something happen here. But a well played in by McDonough and his foursome. They went to that aggressive strategy right from the beginning, and certainly has paid off for him here.
Yeah, when you're skipping and you get to throw two guards, your team has been playing well, and it's a good thing. So it looks like he's going to play the...
question is what kind of weight, though, Marion? Is he going to play it with a takeout weight, or are we going to look at a hack weight instead of tap shot, or is it back line, just try to bump it to the forefoot? I think that's what they're discussing right now, is what kind of weight do I want to throw here? I think he prefers the outturn. So is this a straight tap shot to the button?
Oh, that ice. I'd say that it is. He needs to cross the rock and hit it about 7/8 on anxiously.
Looks like a, kind of a hack weight kind of shot, but it's holding that center line. Needs to curl for him a little more.
It's coming.
Here it comes.
It's coming. It's coming.
Looking pretty good. Looking pretty good.
Oh, that. Oh, he may still have it.
Oh, what an effort.
That was an excellent rock. That had curled one more inch.
One
he had that
inch.
Perfectly. That was very well
that
thrown.
Was a very well
a lot
thrown
of pressure
rock.
In that shot. It was
you
well
got
thrown.
That right. A ton of pressure on that shot.
So we're heading into the 10th end with Team McDonah up 3, 7-4. So I see that Team McDonough's opted to throw this first rock away. Certainly a strategy that is pretty common when you're up 3 coming home to have less rocks in play. And well, coach used to say you throw one through, you're giving up 2 for sure. So it's a good strategy, but now you have to execute the rest of the end to make sure that...
No question, and we've seen the second stone can throw the high hard one, so that's a key component when you're playing the strategy. You're playing the peel game. Intention is to peel out as many rocks as you can. Once that free guard zone opportunity it presents itself, that you can get at them, and we'll see how that that unfolds. So you've got a good looking rock coming in here from the lead stone for the Lefort group. And so that's one corner guard. Now,
so it looks like they're going to give a go at the tick shot.
Goal here is to make an effort to move that stone, possibly either into the house or move it off to the side even further if they can without removing it from play. As we know, it's in the free guard zone.
It's so close.
It's gonna be close.
It's very close.
I moved it over to the other side,
It's a hard shot. He hit just a tad more of that, but very, very hard shot.
So the key here now is get a second corner guard up and play. Sweepers are working it a bit. It's got good line.
It's got lots of weight. I'm not quite sure. I don't think they need to worry about the... they do want them to be even. That's very important because you'll set up a double peel if they're not approximately the same.
Two good
Yeah, very
stones,
nice.
Well thrown.
They're both thrown by Aidan McNutt. And Aidan started curling at... age 7 from my math here. It says he's 16 and start curling 9 years.
Mm-hmm.
Very nice. Alex threw a nice rock there.
Nice peel there. That's a nice throw.
That's can be quite a pressure shot in the 10th end of a big game like this in a provincial championship. Get a little pumped up and sometimes not throw those as nice. So it's good to see they're staying calm.
Now Reece coming into the pack here. He's got to throw, continue to throw those corner guards and continue to get the guards up there to build the end.
I noticed that Reece likes to play doubles as well. That's good to see. The doubles is now an Olympic sport for curling as well. So it's good to see some young people taking an interest in doubles.
Yeah, mixed doubles is really growing in our sport for sure. Another nice corner guard.
Very nice. Well played.
Alex just having a quick peek at which one he was thinking of peeling. It's a good call here to go right back to the same spot. Good confidence for your thrower that just threw the same shot. So looks like he's a little tight on that one. The sweeper's going to have to work to get this back out, but working hard on it. I think they've got enough.
They got it.
Good sweep. They hauled that back out. Good sweep by the McDonah sweepers.
Those boys are strong boys. David McCurdy's from a dairy farm, and notice this year he's looking pretty strong. Working hard on the farm, I'm sure, when he's not playing his sports and going to school.
Another corner guard up here, but pretty soon he's going to have to make a decision to tuck one around that existing corner guard. This one here is going to be a little higher, I think. I think Evan might have a look at this, but he might have a chance of trying it. Yeah, he's making that call.
Yeah, he's making the call. See if they can get them both. Key here is not to think about that too much. And
important to make the top one go away.
Yeah.
And slash double is a bonus.
It's important to keep sweeping that. It's important to keep sweeping that right over.
Yeah. That was a good, good throw. So now he's trying to come in here now. This one here is kind of important. You got to get this right to the tee line because you got to make room.
Well,
to get
actually, I like this one even back 12 fully buried. You have to make room for more rocks behind there. If you put this one too high, you've taken away your own scoring area.
Question is, they had some trouble with the ice over here, and the last time that it curled hard and came off that center line.
I see it happening again.
I think so. I don't think that weight was quite there either. Just a little shy on the weight, but nevertheless, still some rocks in play that can come to their advantage if they get the opportunity.
I think this is just a straight peel. This is not.
And this is a good call here. Yeah. You know, you want to make sure you get rid of one for sure.
And the top one being the most dangerous. Very
good
nice.
So now
we're down with three rocks left to play, and they need all three to count, so it's very important that this one gets fully buried at the back of the house, and see what happens from there. They can take lots of time setting up, still 5.5 minutes on the clock, no pressure that way. Got lots of weight.
That's a 360 split time, so that's
it's got lots of line and lots of weight.
It's been about tee line. 360 has been top of the house tee line, but this one seems to be gliding along here. Certainly going to be in play.
The weight's absolutely perfect, unfortunately. Not buried, but...
appears to be wide open. It's an excellent weight. Well, Mary, it's been a lot of fun working with you this afternoon. Really enjoyed it. And by the way, happy anniversary.
Yeah, happy anniversary to you too. We thought it was kind of fitting that we would commentate curling today on our anniversary, since that's how we met. Curling on the curling circuit a number of years ago. So curling's a passion of both of ours, and this has been a lot of fun.
Throwing it pretty good. No hard sweep yet. Working pretty hard at it.
And there it goes.
There it goes.
And the handshakes come out. So, McDonah team victorious. Well, and I have to say that I really enjoy watching both teams. Both teams look like they work really hard at the sport. Lots of great etiquette and sportsmanship, and wish the both teams well for the rest of the tournament.
All right. Good curling out here, folks. If you get a chance to drop into the Amherst Curling Club and watch some of this great junior curling, drop on in there on for another couple days to go here. So, as they say, good luck and good curling, and signing off for now.